was asking about. In recent times, we've had urban spaces that councils or elected representatives have given over to corporations if they take care of maintenance, lighting, cleaning, all those kind of services. And as a trade-off, they get to dictate what those spaces are used for. They police the spaces, they have wardens in place, and they effectively can seal off urban spaces as private property from people who wish to make, say, for example, peaceful protest or perform free art in an open space. Has the National Trust come into any form of sort of obstacle in relation to that? Or does the National Trust have a position in relation to the surrender of our free urban spaces?
Okay, good question. The answer is no. So we have a problem in urban spaces. We don't have much property interest in urban areas. So we haven't been involved in those debates. This is the stuff of debate for everyone here today as part of the new Putney debates, I guess. Not something the Trust necessarily has been involved in, but we are involved in plots of urban land, and we are wanting to explore how we can potentially be more relevant to the people of this country. We were set up for everyone, for the nation. We're here to provide public benefit. If most people live in cities, which they do, and they're disconnected from the National Trust, that we've got a problem on our hands. And what is it we can do potentially to work with urban communities? So in the Peak District, for example, we've just taken on the lease of a big chunk of it's open space, actually. It's part of the High Peaks near Sheffield. We've taken it on from the City Council. The City Council owned it because of its importance to urban communities in Sheffield. We've taken it on to demonstrate how we can look after this space and provide that continuity of public access. So I suppose we're demonstrating through doing rather than through necessarily getting involved in these debates about public-private space in urban areas.
Access, is it about people's ability to pay, or is it about public access to actually be able to use the land?
And we don't charge in lots of our open spaces, most of them actually. So you pay if you want to get into a property, but we don't. Most of our places don't have a...
Is it about people being able to use the land to grow food and things like that?
It can be. So we've been doing lots of work around allotments and wanting to... So recognising we've got quite a large land holding, we had a plan to create 1,000 allotments, and we've done that up and down the country in different places. Lots of National Trust properties work with local communities for things like allotment gardening and things like that. So you'll find it anywhere you go, actually.
Thank you. Okay, I think we'll have to wrap it up here. Quite a lot of things to go through. So thank you so much, Ben. It's been a lovely talk, and your
thank you. Pleasure.